Hi. Hi, I'm Nupur Dave and I help NRIs get clarity on where they should live. I'm also writing my third book for single NRIs. The most common question I get asked from NRIs is, will I regret moving to India? So let me answer that with my own experience. Do I regret moving? So the short answer is no, and the long answer is also no. You were not expecting that, right? If you want the full story, you can check out my book. I've written a book called Back Home. I'm going to link it in the comments below. But let me tell you why I don't regret my move from the US to India. I lived in the United States for 13 years and then moved back to India after that. Reason one is that I tried everything in the United States. So before moving back to India, I really tried to find happiness. I moved jobs, I moved locations, I changed houses. I've moved 11 houses in 13 years. I've shaken things up, but nothing seemed to work. So despite having everything, I was still unhappy. And I felt at that time that India was the answer that I hadn't explored. The second reason I don't regret is that by that time, by 13 years, I had taken the juice out of life in America. Like, I had experienced so much. I had run marathons by then. And yes, I mean the 26.2 miles wala marathon, not the 10K one. I worked for the top company. I had thousands of friends. I was really super fit. I traveled also a lot domestically as well as internationally. So there wasn't something that I hadn't done. And reason number three, one of the major reasons for my successful transition was that I have a great anchor and a great reason, which is my family. And my family helped me get that mental support that I was kind of missing in the United States. So now you could ask, when do you actually regret moving? And what I've seen with the numerous NRI clients that I've worked with, there are some portion that have regretted moving. And it's often that they move back with the wrong expectations. Like, they're expecting that their job will be better and it turned out to be something else, or they're expecting to have instant friends. And usually it's a mix of a lot of things together, mostly around expectations that make them unhappy. Having family as my anchor provided the support and stability I needed to adjust and thrive. And a lot of these folks may not have that kind of family support, or even if they do, they don't have the right expectations. So it's a combination of a lot of things. And still, right, I don't want you to think that I have no regrets. I do have some regrets, but they are not about moving to India. They are about the type of life that I lived in the United States. And that's one of the reasons why I do the work that I'm doing and the books that I'm writing, is to help NRIs not lead a life where they would look back and regret it. So kind of learn from my fail. So the regrets that I have about the type of life I lived was, I wish I had lived a better quality life. Like, I could have spent more money. I could have been less scared about things and enjoyed my time a little more. Like, even something like airport anxiety used to really get to me. I traveled a lot. And as most of you know, no amount of travel is enough. I still feel like, why didn't I travel more? But you know, these regrets are kind of minor compared to the overall fulfillment I found since I've moved back. The experiences, the sense of being together and really being close to family. Something as simple as that at 1 o'clock in the afternoon, I can call up my family and talk to them, or 3 p.m. in the afternoon, which is something I couldn't do in the United States because of the time difference. I can do that here. And that kind of support has really helped me feel no regret. It has sort of plugged that hole that I found was missing. So no, I don't regret moving to India. So if you're considering such a move and you're thinking about, oh, will I regret it? Know that it's all about finding what feels right for you at the right phase of your life. The key is to understand the difference between what is your gut telling you versus what is just simple anxiety. So if you're getting anxiety about moving to India, is that your gut telling you that this is not the right time, or is it just fear of the unknown? And in order to be able to separate these two out, you can do what I did, which is taking out the juice from America or wherever you're living and trying different things, like change things up, change your job, change your location, change your apartment. See if that makes a difference to you. And when you've tried everything, you may realize that, you know what, I'm still not feeling happy. Or you might just calm down because maybe you found a job that you really like. So you never know until you try. Now you could say that, hey, I don't have the bandwidth and I don't have the appetite and I don't have the flexibility to try different things. Absolutely a concern, especially for people who are in marriages and have kids. But still, it is still in your head. You can still make changes. It's not impossible. I need you to brave this out. Hang in there. You've got it. If you want to dive deeper into my journey, read my book Back Home. I've got a lot of tips for NRIs who are confused about moving to India. And I want you to know that you are not alone. There are so many people who are in the same boat as you and have made the plunge to India. And you know what? Maybe they regretted it, but in the end, you get used to certain things and you start accepting life. It's not that bad, really. Great. I hope this helps. Hang in there. Nupur Dave here. I write and I talk about NRI life and ex-NRI life. So follow me for more NRI versus ex-NRI content. And see you around.